Hi to all. In this video you will see and learn how to program and set up a modern high-performance RC glider. In this case, the Experience Pro FFJ. So stay tuned and more will follow after the intro.
The several brand KST have sent me over their latest product, which is the HS08 servo. It has 10 gram and has absolutely amazing performance data. It has nearly the same dimensions as the X08 servo, and I have built it into the Experience Pro. But you will see some photos from this in the next videos.
So before I show you all the throws and the different flight modes on the airplane, I will show how I control these functions from my transmitter. And so starting with the motor, how can I show you the best? So I have a throttle slider on my back plate, so front, back. So with this slider, I can control how much throttle I want to have. And I can turn on the motor with this switch. So if this switch is turned off, I cannot give any power or can control anything. So it's for safety reason and important in FFJ that you don't turn off the motor when you don't want it. So then coming to the other function, so I play mode 1 on my transmitter. That means I have elevator on this stick, on the left stick, and rudder on the left stick, and aileron on the right stick. And in this case, I have not the throttle on the right stick, I have here on my right stick the butterfly, so the brakes. To get more performance out of the airplane, it's important to use some flight modes. So that means different setups for the flaps with different angles and camber settings, and the aileron as well, and also the elevator. So these functions do I have on these switches here. Okay, I'll show you the best. So when you look on the transmitter on this left switch, so the upper switch, when this one is in the middle position, I have my normal standard mode. So, which means everything is in neutral. You will see it later. When I have it upwards, this is a speed setting. And when I put it all the way down, this is the thermal mode. And in this thermal mode, I have also two versions or two different settings, which are can control over that switch here. So when it's upwards, it's thermal 1, and when I put the switch downwards, it's thermal 2. So yeah, that's the basic settings. And now let's turn on the airplane and you will see it's live how they look like on the airplane. So now I can show you the thing with the throttle slider and my throttle switch. So it's now on a minimum setting from my throttle. And when I now switch on, it will rotate. And over the slider, I can control how much power I want. I hope you heard me. So that's the first one, and so now I'm in the standard neutral position. So you hear it already, the servos that are changing their position. And yeah, so now let's jump over to the aileron, the elevator, and so nothing ultra special. Basically the most important function on the airplane. So let me take a look here. And I'm giving upwards, downwards. Yeah, here in general, I always use all the throw that I can get downwards. So, yeah, because it's easier for the landing. And exactly, in especially when you do want to do a timed landing on a landing point. And then I have a rudder. Also, nothing ultra special. yeah. So here I have also, of course, a symmetrical throw. And yeah, then coming to the aileron. So yeah. So with the differential, some rule of thumb is that so the throw downwards should be 1/3 of the throw upwards. It can vary from plane to plane, but yeah, that's a good rule of thumb in my opinion. And you already have seen it maybe. I use some aileron to flap mix. That means when I give aileron, in this case to the right side, the flap will also move in the same direction, but not that much, of course, as the aileron itself. We can take a look at my transmitter, what the exact value is. That menu is in German, so I hope you get along it. So here I have aileron on flaps, and it's 19% in this case. So, but you need to look that the movement has the same relation upwards to downwards as the aileron. So on Yeti you can do this when it's not already right. Yeah, as in this case also, you can do this by changing the value for the movement downwards, in this case that one, compared to the upward movement. And yeah, so we have the aileron. Then we will take a look at the different flight modes. So this is at the moment the neutral position. That means yeah, for all the flying that that you have a little bit higher airspeed, and when I have also the speed mode. So on this plane, it's not too much, basically some 2 or 3 millimeters upwards, and the ailerons are moving the same way upwards. So always we are always aligning, except the thermal 2 mode. And then I will come to the thermal 1 mode. So when the flaps and the aileron move downwards, in this case also 2 millimeters, around 2 millimeters, and yeah, the ailerons and flaps are also aligned in one row. And then coming to the thermal 2 mode, so this is a little bit different compared to the other flight modes. So here we have a lot more camber, and yeah, so let me guess, in this case around 7 millimeters or 8 millimeters, and the ailerons are not aligned in this flight mode. This is because that plane gets a little bit tip stall when you move the ailerons too much down, and so you need to adjust it on that plane. And yeah, so these are the different flight modes. Really important is that you have the aileron, the elevator trim, independent for all flight modes. So that means yeah, you can trim it all separate, so you have no general trim for all the flight modes. On some transmitters, you need to set up this at first when you make a new model. So I can show it you. So when I trim here, you see here my trim value. Here my trim switch. And when I switch over, you see that my trim value also changes. So that's really important. So trim always separate for each flight condition or flight mode. And so basically these were the most important functions. So if you want to have it a little bit easier, there's also I would suggest you to use only a neutral mode and a thermal one mode. So that's already enough for normal flying. So something like this and a neutral mode. And when you want to get out even more performance, then a thermal two mode is also useful, and speed mode as well. And then coming to another function, when I give the elevator upwards, my flaps will move downwards. So it's in German called snap flap, I think in English as well. So when I give elevator upwards, my flaps will move downwards. And also when I give elevator downwards, my flaps will move upwards. So more important is that when you give elevator upwards, that your flaps move downwards. And here's a good rule of thumb that when you so for the value of a snap flap, when you give a full elevator upwards, the throw for the flaps downwards should be that much at the next flight mode is. So for example, this is the thermal one mode, and when you have the neutral flight mode, it should move with full elevator that throw downwards in that position as the flight mode two is. So in this case, it's a little bit more, but just as a rule of thumb. And when you move it upwards, that's the same rule of thumb. So in neutral position, from neutral position, when I give full elevator down, it will move upwards as speed mode is in a standard position. So as you see here, that's without elevator. And when I have the speed mode without elevator, and when I switch over to the neutral mode, and I give full elevator down, it will move that way upwards. And so here in thermal one, snap flap goes down to thermal two, around, nearly as around, or goes down to thermal two. On this plane, it's special that I only moved in thermal one. The flaps downwards and not the ailerons, because it also gets tip stall when you get when the ailerons move too much down. Yeah. To be clear, you can fly, of course, even without snap flap at all. But now coming to butterfly. So that I've, as I already said, on my throttle stick normally, or on my stick where normally throttle is. And so I need to lay down my camera here. So when I, so here you will see now That's half butterfly. So, and now moving my stick even further down. So this is full break, around 80 degree. Of course, you can use more, but yeah, that's kind of a sweet spot. And yeah, it's not completely symmetrical. You see, but yeah. Just for the showing purpose, it's enough. So when I give full butterfly, this is a full throw downwards. So butterfly, that means when you put when you give full flaps downwards, that the ailerons move upwards. So that you basically see here. Aileron will move upwards. And so I can show you the value. In the past I had also more throw upwards, but you don't need that. The flaps are that huge that you don't need that much value upwards on the flaps. So when I switch over to flap settings, so when I have all the flaps down, that means I have this value here. So 170%, but yeah, that says nothing. And the aileron movement upwards is 35%, so I think that's a value that you can work with. But always that throw, that average number depends on your whole throw upwards that you have. And when you use a butterfly, of course, you need also to mix some elevator downwards to it, because otherwise the airplane will, when you fly in that direction and you will use butterfly, you have no mixture on elevator, it will move or it will fly upwards, because the wing develops some lift. It also develops some drag, but of course some lift as well. So you need to use some elevator downwards to compensate it. And you will see it here. So when I give, when I use some flaps, so now full flap, and here you will see, difficult to see. And here you will see, out of focus, where is it? You will see the movement downwards. So, yeah. So, full flaps, and that's the elevator downwards. And we can also take a look on the value that I use here. And it's 30%. So yeah, also here a good rule of thumb is normally between 30% and 45% is that number on the modern planes. But of course this is depending on the tail type and the size of the aileron, the aileron flaps and the elevator. So I hope I have shown you now all the settings. And haven't forget anything. I hope also that my English was not that bad, because it's always difficult for me. I'm living in German, in the Swabian region, so I need to get along with English language and with my Swabian dialect. So it's not that easy always. But I hope it was explained well to you. If you have any questions, feel free to ask them. And if you have any ideas with the experience that I can show you in future. Also write down in the comment section. So I will upload this week 2 more videos with the Experience Pro. You will see the exact date on the video here. And so one video is where I do some aerobatic flying and one video where I do some thermal soaring. So if you don't want to miss them, make sure you subscribe to the YouTube channel here. And I hope you enjoyed watching this video. See you next time and goodbye.